It's okay. We all have one, and no one knows the right way to deal with it. It's uncomfortable and awkward, and you don't want to admit that it's a real problem. That's right. Today, we're going to talk about fixing your Wi-Fi dead spots with mesh networks. Odds are, right now, you have one Wi-Fi access point set up somewhere in your house. An access point is a Wi-Fi radio that creates a wireless hotspot in your house. It's probably either built into the modem that's provided by your ISP, or in a box that's sitting next to that modem as part of your router. Your Wi-Fi access point will create a torus-shaped area of good, strong Wi-Fi in your house. A donut of good internet, if you will. When you're inside the donut of good internet, you're blessed by bars and your signal's good. Your browsers scroll, your videos load quickly, and your group chats are always popping off. But what happens when you're outside the Wi-Fi donut? It's a sad, lonely, and sporadically connected place. Videos take forever to load. Pages load ever so slowly, and you may even have trouble sending status updates. So what's the solution? Well, you could knock a bunch of holes in your walls and run Ethernet cables and wire up a bunch of commercial networking gear, or you could replace your Wi-Fi setup with a fancy new mesh network. Mesh networks utilize multiple access points, also called mesh nodes, connected to each other using either dedicated radios or wired Ethernet if your house is equipped with it. When set up properly, mesh networks will seamlessly improve coverage throughout your house and get rid of dead spots once and for all. The setup process is pretty much the same for all mesh networks, but the specifics will vary by brand. You'll start by connecting your main mesh node, typically the one with multiple Ethernet ports, to your ISP-provided modem. Then you'll install an app on your phone that will walk you through the rest of the configuration steps for the network. The app will ensure that your Wi-Fi network's name and security settings are configured so that all of your Wi-Fi devices can seamlessly move from mesh node to mesh node as you move throughout the house. The one place to take your time and follow the step-by-step guidance is when the app is helping you find the best locations for your secondary mesh nodes. If you have wired Ethernet in your house, take advantage of it. Wired connections are typically faster and more reliable than wireless connections. But if you don't have Ethernet, don't worry about it. The wireless connections will work great if you set them up properly. You'll want to find an out-of-the-way spot in each room that's near a power connection that you can plug the mesh node into. Finding the perfect spot can be tricky to do manually, but the apps will help you find the perfect balance of signal strength and coverage area. If you set up a mesh node too far away from another node, your signal might be sketchy, even though your phone reports full bars. At the same time, if you set up your nodes too close to each other, you might not get the kind of coverage that you're paying for. And if you're having a tough time, don't sweat it. You can always rerun the tool later and make adjustments if you find any dead spots. Mesh networks are awesome and will make your Wi-Fi work better everywhere, even in that out-of-the-way bathroom in the attic.